subscribe and hit the notification bell to help us achieve the 300K mortal plan. Every soul counts. Every once in a while, an OC breaks the confines of being an OC and becomes something a little bit more. And if you guys don't know what an OC is, it basically just means original character, and Dragon Ball has a ton of them. I've told their stories on this channel. I've supported the artists and the creators through this channel and on Twitter and wherever else I can, sharing their ideas and posting their characters here, as well as making even videos talking about Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, which I think really pushes a lot of OC creation, not only through the video game, but through artwork online. But again, there is one character that really pushes itself not only past nonfiction, but also pushes itself into the realm of plausible canon. And that is the story of Zukina, the daughter of Broly and Chilai. Now, the son of Broly has already been implemented as a Dragon Ball fan manga. I covered it myself, and I will leave a link to it in the description below so you guys can go ahead and check it out. Check out that video series where I talk about the kid of this legendary Super Saiyan. But we have now a daughter of this legendary Super Saiyan, a daughter of both Broly and Chilai, and she is called Zukina. Now, Zukina herself does not have a Dragon Ball fan manga yet, so if anybody would like to make a Dragon Ball fan manga for this character, I highly encourage you to do so. Post it on DeviantArt, Twitter, and make sure to give credit to the original creator, who I can only assume is JRaynor3 on DeviantArt. Now, most, if not all, the artwork that is for this OC character is on this DeviantArt page. It seems like this is the creation of JRaynor3, who decided to make a daughter design for Broly and Chilai, and I've seen a few designs of the children of Broly and Chilai, and the one thing I like about all of them is that all of them have the white hair as being the base hair for the creation. Now, this one in particular is a little bit more interesting because not only does she have the white hair, but her skin is a little bit darker to show that it is a mixture between the tan skin that Broly has and the light green skin that Chilai has. And in particular, I love this design because it is basically the Super Saiyan hair, obviously white, and she has a tail, a white tail at that. So it is definitely a good mix of both the characteristics between Broly and Chilai, in my opinion, giving us a brand new character with a name that definitely follows the Saiyan puns for vegetables. Now, one of my favorite parts of the Zukina design is the wardrobe. The wardrobe specifically is very interesting because she is dressed in Ba fur. Now, it's not quite certain where she got this Ba fur. Like, it is extra Ba fur that sheds off the creature, the monster, or if another Ba had an accident and lost an ear and she used that as clothing. I definitely like that this seems to be like the native style of Vampa. This is something that is very inherent to the culture of the one family that lives on planet Vampa, and I definitely like that its integration into this character OC design. But one of the most interesting aspects of this, and I'm not exactly sure why this is the case, but a lot of the art has, of course, the green hair for the Zukina design. Yes, she transforms into something that is very similar to what Broly looks like. Bright green hair, and she seems to have a better handle on Berserk. But there's also an extra addition to this design, and that is when Zukina finally does go Berserk, her hair turns into the exact same teal looking color that we see from the original Broly when he is still wearing the mind control slash power suppression necklace that he has from Paragus in that movie. It's the exact same teal look. I definitely like that version of Broly. There was one version of him like this in Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 3 that I definitely did enjoy, and I definitely like the teal color to it. But there is also more expanded designs that have this teal color as a Super Saiyan 3 variant that doesn't look like she's berserk, looks like she's far more controlled. And we do see her also in a Super Saiyan variant where her hair is extra spiky. We see her have longer hair than her original design, more of a combination of the original haircut that she has and a ponytail. And we also get to see even an entire transformation sheet of what exactly her various forms look like, where we see her base form, we see a powered up version of her base form with spiky hair, we see a Super Saiyan, we see Berserk, and then we see her Uzaru form, which I'm thinking that she would get on planet Earth because I don't believe that planet Vampa has any moons. So I have a lot of love for this design, and I definitely like and appreciate the fact that there was so much thought and effort put into what exactly the daughter of Broly and Chi-Lai may not only look like, but what her transformations may actually end up being. Now, with that said, what is my prediction as to what the daughter of Broly and Chi-Lai may look like? Again, I like this design a lot. I definitely like the way that she looks, and I definitely like what she's wearing. The only change that I would make is that I would make her skin just green, lime green, similar to her mother's. That way she looks closer to her as well as closer to Broly. On top of that, I would make her a very sweet girl, very caring girl, but very spunky and much more similar to Chi-Lai than Broly in the personality department. Imagine if Chi-Lai was a Saiyan, that's exactly what I would be thinking of, mainly due to the fact that I like Chi-Lai's personality a lot better. I really don't think that Broly has much of a personality to begin with, not at this stage anyway. I would have her discover Super Saiyan with Broly on planet Vampa and then go straight into the Berserker stage. Love the teal color on the hair, definitely keeping that. But honestly, I would love for her to have her own version of Ikari. I think that would be pretty dope to see. And I cannot wait to see if there are any other implementations and other artwork for Zekina that come in the future. Thank you guys so much for watching the video and making it to this point of the video. The more of the video to watch, the better it does in the algorithm. You guys are awesome. Let's see who won hashtag end of video squad. The winner of today's hashtag end of video squad, the soul that decided to stay till the very end of my previous video and drop hashtag end of video squad on their comment, is going to be Z-Man123. Christmas time plus New Year's. Do you think we'll get Dragon Ball Christmas fan mangas? I looked through the majority of what I could find, and this one in particular, the Veggie Bowl Christmas, is really the only one that's really, really Christmas. I found a smaller one in Dragon Ball Multiverse, like a one-off, that maybe I'll cover this month, seeing as how it is Christmas month, but we'll see about that. There aren't really that many, but if you guys know of any, make sure you guys send them to me on Twitter or let me know here. Thank you so much for your comment, Z-Man. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Take care, guys.
Subscribe for more content.